Y'all already know what's going on, man. It's me, the Goaty, Fly Guy DC, Isolation Insider, the Streets Edition, baby. We back, better, bigger, season two. And listen, it's only right. Season two, episode one. I gotta do it the right way. I gotta open it up the right way. The big stepper, the girlfriend, ass caresser, well-known flexer is in the motherfucking building.
Yeah, you know what it is.
How you doing, my brother?
I'm working, man. I'm here.
First and foremost, congratulations on everything that you've gained, you've experienced, you've prospered, you've manifested. I just have to say, brother to brother, I'm extremely proud of you, man. Like,
I appreciate it.
You coming here in 2016, 2017, and winning a contest and having an interview that many years ago, and then everything just blossoming, man. The shit feels amazing because it's like I helped in that in some atmosphere.
Nah, for sure.
Like, and it's like we spoke that shit into existence when you was here. So just first and foremost, like how's life been outside of music? I mean, we in a pandemic, and just how's life been?
Man, so like, well, I won't lie, what they've been like, what they consider me to be like. You know, they consider a nigga to be like pandemic proof.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, they said a nigga blew up in the middle of a pandemic, right? And that shit real. So, I don't know, life been good, bro. Life been good. But this, like, so, like, boom, like, even, like, you know, with the project and shit, like, with everything that's about to happen, like, that, like, this project for people like you, you feel me? Like, people like Flip, you know, people like, you know, like the people that helped me get to where I'm at, like thank y'all for believing. So like all like everything, I've been good, bro. I've been blessed.
Now speaking of a pandemic, a lot of artists went down in the pandemic.
I don't know how.
Because they wasn't creative. The pandemic opened up a creative side of artists, and you excelled on that aspect.
Yeah.
What kept you level headed or ground headed during the pandemic to where you was like, nah, I still gotta do it, I gotta get more creative? Because I felt like you're super talented. I'm not just saying that because I know you or because you're right here. Like, you're extremely talented, but it's like when the pandemic hit, another side of you came out.
Yeah, man, like, when you know what you come from, feel me? Like, it's just like, you can't, if you're not trying to go back to that, you're not gonna, like, fold under pressure. You're not gonna, like, I can't make no excuses. Like, this is something that happened to the world. It ain't only happened to me, it happened to everybody. So, like, how I'm gonna just make excuses? Like, man, if this ain't happened to me, I would've, it happened to everybody. You feel me? So, ain't no excuses.
Now, I see that, I wanna, like, yeah, see, 2017, you came up here, won a contest, and I see you still got the same person or the same people around you that was with you then. How important is that to keep the people that started with you, especially when they've been there through the grind, they've been there through the hustle, and they're around for the right reasons rather than the wrong reasons?
I mean, you know, you basically said it, like, they're around for the right reasons, not the wrong reasons, you know, like, keep the right people around you. It ain't really hard to keep the wrong people, around you. Like, the wrong people will fade away by themselves. Like, they'll make the wrong decisions, and you'll see it, and no one will attend to it no more. You know what I mean? Like from, like, Flip, my manager, you know, like, Arnold Taylor, like, all of them, like, feel me? Like, that's, like, it's more than just me being signed to them. Like, that's, like, big bro. How you big bro? Like, they big bro. Like, I could call them about anything. Like, you feel me? So, I don't know. I don't do people. I'm keeping 100. I don't do people. I love everybody, but I don't do people. Like, I don't just let everybody in. But I fuck with everybody. I don't do people, though.
Solid. Now, how's the road life? Because it was a pandemic, and you literally, like, legit, like, blew up in a pandemic, but now you're starting to, that road money is coming in, and those road shows are coming. So how is that like?
Man, it's a blessing. Like, it's crazy. Beforehand, like I got a girlfriend now.
Yeah, we gonna talk about that.
I got a girlfriend now, but like beforehand, like, we used to turn up on the road. Like, that was the life we used to live. We used to turn up. Now, you know, mama's with me everywhere.
Yeah,
she at the solace. You know what I mean? So it's a blessing though, bro. It's, you know what I mean? get the money and do the right things with it. That's all I try to do.
Now, speaking of girlfriend, how long have you, because I seen the Instagram post with the Valentine's Day, the boat and all that. Yeah. So how long has this been going on?
So we've been dealing with each other for almost a year now. Dealing with each other for almost a year, and then I met my girlfriend on Valentine's Day.
So what made you wanted to take that next step and make her your girlfriend?
Because I was messing with her for, I was messing around with her for like 9 months. And I just got tired of the females. I got tired of the females. I'm like, you know, this fun, like messing with little females, yeah. That's fun, but I rock with shorty. A lot of people don't know, like when you get into a relationship though, it ain't easy. It ain't easy. So you gotta really be willing to take that next step. And I was like, man, like whatever. Let's do it.
And how old are you, if you don't mind me asking?
I'm 21.
And you took that next step in the beginning of you becoming a top tier artist, which shows your maturity and it shows the growth. Because when you came here in 2017, you was nothing like this.
Not at all.
You was nothing like this at all. Like, so yeah, so like I see the growth definitely. I see it's everything just, it's like it's hitting for you. So do you love her?
Oh yeah, for sure. I love her. I'm obsessed with my girl. I got her at my lock screen.
Lock screen. Do y'all see lock screen? That's how you know it's real. He just changed that. Lock screen. That's hard. Now, speaking to, for you to be 21, speaking to all the young artists out there who scared to show their relationship or scared to be in love or dealing with somebody because they like the perks that come with the lifestyle. Like, how important is it to have a shawty by your side who's holding you down?
I mean, the lifestyle, cool, but like, I'm gonna keep it 100. It's more about building the relationships. You feel me? Like, the relationships is more important. Like, well, the relationship is more important. Like, my girl, my friend, like, that's my best friend. We argue, we fight, like, talk about. We do little childish shit, like have Nerf war guns. Like, you know what I mean? Like we do it all. That's my girl. That's my best friend. So it's like, it's never boring. It's never a dull moment. We be chilling. She complain a little bit. I complain a little bit. We argue.
But it's ups and downs.
That's, man, that's my best friend. Fuck it. I got a best friend for life. I'm good money. That's my baby.
That's solid. Listen, man, it ain't too many 21-year-old artists who are as big as you or even on your level that has that mentality. And I think it's real good for the culture and real good for the game in general, because everybody gets so misconstrued and think that, yeah, I gotta be fucking this girl, or I'm not gonna get looked at like everybody else. But you're doing it the right way. You got your shorty, you're faithful to her, she's your screen saver, you're showing her off, she's with you everywhere, and you're still toosie. So it's like,
see, but this thing though, like the screensaver and all that, like the shit that people see on the internet, all that, like, really, like, that's just puppy love. Like, that's me and puppy love. Like, I'm a puppy love. But, like, at the end of the day, ain't no, they gotta know it come with, like, it come with pros and cons. Like, ain't nobody perfect. Motherfuckers gonna make mistakes. You gotta think, like, this motherfucker you gonna be with for the rest of your life. Like, yo, I'm gonna keep it 100. Like, it's gonna be ups and downs. Like, but as long as you keep it 100, like, in your relationship, keep it 100 always, I promise you, you'll be good. Like, and a person either gonna wanna deal with it or they ain't. Like, just depending on what type of person you is. Like, I'm the type of person, like, I don't need more than one motherfucker to stroke my ego. Like, I'm good money with one.
So my question to you, and this might be a little too personal, but, and I'm only asking just so that all the young niggas out there can know, like, you can't fuck up and still. So in this midst of you dealing with shawty, and not even a girlfriend portion, when you was dealing with her for the 9 months previously, did you fuck up or make mistakes?
Yeah, I was dealing with other females, but I sat down with her, and I told her, like, look, listen, like, yo, and it broke me. Like, that's how I knew I really liked her. Because I'm like, damn, like,
hurting her hurt you.
Yeah, I'm like, yo,
that's how you know it's
you're
real.
Not even my girlfriend yet.
Yeah.
Feel me? I'm like, yo, look, listen. Like, I told her straight up. I'm like, yo, listen. I fucked this girl right here. Like, I'm gonna keep it on it. Like, told her, like, straight up, like, this is before she was my girlfriend. She, yeah. She really can't be
can't
mad.
Do me, yeah,
ain't in no relationship. Man, I fucked this girl right here. Like, keep it on it. Like, I don't really fuck with that shit. Boom. All right. She was hurt a little bit. We moved on from it. But I told her.
Solid.
I told her.
Well, listen, man. We ain't going nowhere. We got to take a quick break real quick. Because we got to break What It Calls live on the radio. So y'all going to get to witness this shit too. Come on, man. Talk to me nice. Come on, talk to me twice. I've been in my bed. Paranoid. I've got PTSD. Study in my bed. I can be ready. I got you. You know what to do. See? Y'all think it's a game. I told y'all, we don't play fair over here, okay?
We don't play fair over here,
DJ, okay? Showtime.
Yeah.
The big stepper is in the building.
The well-known flexer in the building.
It's only right you introduce it to the city.
Yeah, it's the big stepper, the well-known flexer, the girlfriend, huh? You know the rest. You dig What It Calls on the radio now. Streets 945, Fly God DC, what it is, man.
Hey, Showtime, hit your drop, Showtime.
Hit your drop, Showtime.
Hit it again, Showtime.
Hit it again.
Talk to me nice. Talk to me nice. Talk to me nice. Oh, we ain't done. Y'all know we make movies over here. Now look, last time I did it, I had him on FaceTime, but he here now.
Oh yeah, so I'm here.
So he gonna witness this shit.
Part two.
Hey, man, this big boy. Wait a minute, man. You got to run that back.
Man, oh man, oh man. I don't think y'all understand.
Uh-huh.
I got a text like a week ago.
A week ago.
And said, hey, bro, this doing way better than this. 93 times better than the first one.
Times better than the first one.
This is no kizzy. No cap. What it calls. Tootsie, Showtime, let's go. Talk to me next time. Talk to me twice. I've been in my bed.
This is a Streets 94.5 exclusive. New stuff. It has to be introduced the right way. Fly God DC.
Don't stop.
Let's go.
Again.
Tootsie, since you here, yeah. Live, DJ Showtime, you're doing an incredible job, my brother.
Uh-huh.
Can you introduce it one more time, live on the radio for everybody that's locked and loaded?
It's the big stepper, the well-known flexer, the girlfriend, baby mama, butt caresser.
Yeah.
You know what it is, yeah. Showtime what it is, Fly God what it is. Live, Uvi.
Y'all know how we rocking. Let's go. Talk to me next time. Talk to me twice. Hey, V-Bay. I'm not one of them. I came from rags, originally traveled back to the red. My new look, when you play, really can't be no dad. I thought you seen it in me, I'm a star. Once it's a rapper, never switch the car. I left the earth and ended up on Mars. Let me be sitting next to the star. I thought you seen it on me, I'm a star. Let me be back by 12, let me care by 6. But I'm here, won't see no bar. Let me look between the walls. Wait, this is in studio video! In studio video!
Talk to me nice, don't talk to me twice. I've been in my bed.
We've been in our bed.
Paranoid, I got PTSD, 30 in my man. I came from rags, the riches ain't trying to go back to the red.
We ain't going back.
My new little bitch been tripping, I ain't really trying to be no dad.
No cap.
Seen it in me, I'm a star. Don't switch to rapping, nigga, switch to car. I left the earth, man, and I got my mom.
They gotta be fucking explained.
I've seen it on me, I got star.
Yep, man, and we are back. Season 2, episode 1.
Isolation Insider, the Streets Edition. And y'all just seen the movie we just made, What It Cost. Brought it back like 5 times live on the radio.
Six.
Ooh, look, there you go. 6 times live on the radio. And like I said, man, before we ended, we was talking relationships. We was talking your growth. We was talking the maturity of you. But let's switch it over and go left field and talk more on the music side and the artist side and your progression just in the game in general. Now, you just dropped Thanks for Believing in Me.
Yeah.
And the project overall is dope. The project overall shows your growth. And I'm talking growth from when I met you in 2017.
Sure.
The project just in general shows how you're elevating. Mm-hmm. Now let's talk about this project.
So, I won't lie, this is the best project I ever recorded. Like, easily. Like, best project I ever recorded. Like, I actually did it in the actual studio this time. Like, and I ain't, like, usually all of my projects, like Love Cycle, like, all of those songs came from a room, a bedroom. Really? Like, this one came from an actual studio with an actual engineer, and I was like engineering like the past songs. This one came from an actual engineer, actual studio, sat with all of the producers who I got these beats from. Like, I really worked on this one for sure. So.
Now, off the project in general, we're gonna bounce around, but stay within the project. Mm-hmm. What song means the most to you on the project, and why?
Means the most, or is my favorite?
Means the most.
Greater Storm. In Greater Storm, I say, you know, ain't got a close friends, because your close friends ain't your close friends. Like, basically, it speak on, like, the things that I've been through, my past, you know, friends that I done, you know, not lost to death, but lost, you know, relationship-wise.
Mm-hmm.
It speak on that topic. So Greater Storm, like, probably, like, hit me the most, for sure.
Okay, now when we jump around, that what means the most? What's your favorite?
My favorite 5-5. Well, I don't know. I'd be changing, but 5-5 with Mulatto.
Mm-hmm.
That's my favorite. So
now, how did that come about? The record with Mulatto.
I recorded it, and like I recorded it, and I had 2 verses on it. It was already done.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, all right, bet. About to get a mix, boom, got a mix. My A&R called me, Chris. He like, Chris Turner, he called me, like, yo, like, how you feel with Mulatto on this? Shit, let's do it. He sent it back, and I heard it, I'm like, damn, like, ain't no way she just snapped like this. Like, all right, boom, this is what we're gonna do, right? Put a verse in the middle, put my first verse here, put my last verse here. That's how we make those songs. That's my favorite song on the project. That shit a summer, like, hit.
Yeah, it's a vibe.
For sure. Like, that shit a vibe. 5-5 with Brown Nine, City High in the back. You know what I mean?
Now, would you talk about anybody in particular in that song?
Nah. You know what I mean? I would, that at that particular moment, I was just, you know.
How tall is your girlfriend? Is she 5'5"?
No, she 5'2". She put some heels on, she'll be 5'5".
Okay. Now, I see the baby.
Yeah.
How's everything just with that in general?
Oh, that, yo, listen. That one right there gonna fuck him up. And we ain't never did no song
together. Yeah.
We ain't never, like, we did a song together, but we ain't never, like, did a song like my song together. Yeah. Like, feel me? So, boom, honestly, like, I see baby, like, you know, baby do his thing, I do my thing, we'll never, like, really talk to each other much, like, we be working.
Mm-hmm.
Shit, boom. So whenever I see him and shit, I'll tell him what I got going on. Like, yo, listen, I'm trying to do this. I'm about to do this right here. This is the path I'm going. This is where I'm going. He give me a few tips. Like, and that's be what it is.
So he's still...
Like a mentor.
Yeah, like a mentor. He's still on that mentor tip, which is a good thing.
For sure.
Now, to take it back 10 steps,
yeah.
The Love Cycle record.
Mm-hmm.
How did the Summer Walker thing happen?
I was on tour with Summer. Like, I was the only boy on tour with Summer Walker. Like, it was me, Melly, it was just me, Melly, and Summer, right? It was only 3 of us.
One girl that came through one time.
Like, one time, though. Yeah, she wasn't here. She wasn't there. Oh, no, I think she signed the LVRA too. Yeah. But like, yeah, like, it was like three of us on the tour. Three of us on the tour, you know what I mean? And like, I used to be performing Love Cycle in summer, like this. Like, she used to come into the room sometimes and be like, yo, like, I loved your performance. Like, I really like that song. And like, she was talking about Love Cycle. So like, boom, it came to a point where like, I bet, like, we gotta put somebody on it. Mm-hmm. My first show, it's crazy, my first show, I did terrible. Like, feel me? Cause I was just coming off tour with Baby. Mm-hmm. I did the Baby tour, and then I did Polo G. Did I do another Baby tour after that? I did another Kirk Baby. Tour. Huh?
The Kirk tour.
I did the Kirk tour with Baby after that. I done been on four tours with Baby. Like, I did the Kirk tour, and like, you sure Polo G wasn't right before summer?
No, it was Baby on Baby, Polo, Kirk,
Summer. Boom. All right, so bet. Boom. Right. I just came off tour with Baby. So I had so much energy mm-hmm. from like watching them perform, right?
Yeah, you was
them
so
throwing,
much.
Them throwing water, like yo, like them tours I was turning up, like the Polo G tour. Oh my God. It was one point where like it was one point where we had showed up late to a show. Like, and I had to go on right before Polo. Like turning up, feel me? Like, which this is like, you know what I mean? Not a lot of, but like, I turned the crowd up. Like, yeah. We was in, where was we? Texas?
It was in Texas.
I think it was Dallas. Was it Dallas? Yeah. No, it wasn't Dallas.
It was on San Antonio.
San Antonio, Texas. Yeah. Boom. I did a show in San Antonio, Texas. Turned it up because I was late. I missed the flight or something like that. Boom. Made it late. Performed right before Polo turned the crowd up, gave them the energy that they needed right before he came out. Yo, they came to us. They like, listen. We want you to go on right before Polo.
And every single time?
Every single time. Before I was even, like, big yet. Yeah. So I'm still, you know, he headlining, and I'm just part of his tour.
Yeah.
All right, boom, right? Summer Walker now, I go on tour with her, and I'm trying to bring that energy. My first show was terrible. Like, I'm talking about
love. Flip, was it terrible?
It was terrible.
Flip, was it terrible?
Yo, it was so terrible. They came to me and they say, yo, bro, like, you can't do that same stuff that you were doing. You can't do that same. I think I even threw water.
You threw water?
I threw water at a Summer Walker concert on all of the girls. On all of the girls. They was mad as hell. But I ain't know no better. Know, like, yeah, I was just, So experience the biggest teacher, bro. Like, experience definitely is the biggest teacher. After that show, next show was like
San Francisco,
roses.
Yeah, you changed it up real, real fast.
You
got to
tell them that record wasn't out.
What, Love Cycle wasn't out? It wasn't.
We went back through this.
We was performing,
and we said,
and it wasn't out yet.
We need a record for these girls, and we went.
It wasn't even out yet. Love
so that record
has been recorded before he signed with anybody.
I recorded that record like 2017,
bro. So the Summer Walker tour basically made y'all put that record out.
Yeah, because it was performing so well on the tour, and it got to a point where like some of the places we was going to, like after a while of performing, like. Probably performing like four or five shows, like the next cities like knew the song
already
because I was posting clips like so boom, like all right, we like we gotta go with this. We went with it and then like came back, like really we came with the remix late.
Mm-hmm.
We came with the remix late. Like if we would have came with the remix sooner, hit radio sooner, like it really would have like way bigger than what it is now. Like it's about to go platinum now.
Yeah, oh,
like
I know.
It'll be platinum probably like the end of this week. Real talk. Damn. The end of this week it'll be platinum. So like, bro, feel me? I mean, like, hey, that's how it came about though. So they came to me. They like, oh, we need somebody to put on this record. Like, some of the one.
Now, 2017. I know 2017, 2018. The music was pain music.
Mm-hmm.
But it was so much of a variety when I first met you.
Yeah.
What made you
shift?
Yeah. What was the shift or what was the turning point to where you was like, nah, this is my lane. This is my pocket. Lane. I gotta stick. I gotta like be right here.
Before I was like, before I really got into making like, not even like, boom, like, not even like the love songs, kind of. Like before I even like really got into like, more so like making that my lane. Mm-hmm. Females was already liking me, mm-hmm. like off of the looks. Like they was liking me because of my personality and my looks. So I'm like I say earlier, like the whole thing with the competitors and the mm-hmm. customers thing. Like this is my customers right here. Like these is the people who love me. These are the people who care about me. Like why I'm like, all right. When you look at Tupac, you look at who else? Like you look at Tupac, you look at Chris Brown, you look at just bro, any major artist like Drake, any of them, like mm-hmm. yo, like most of their fan bases is females. Yeah.
And then a lot of, I don't think a lot of artists understand. I mean, just even if speaking on the radio term, yeah. 70%+ of the listeners are female.
Are female.
Females buy music. Dudes don't really buy music. 70%
dudes gonna buy with the females.
With the females, like, yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Show, so
but majority of females start the wave of everything, and a lot of artists don't understand that.
Real talk, so it's like you gotta find a way to like, you know, find your median. I mean, like in the middle, like I bet, like I love females. Like, you feel me? I don't do nothing for dudes. I love females. But like certain times I gotta give because I'm still like one of them.
Yeah.
You know? So like you just gotta be able to, like this project right here. From the intro, like the intro ain't no love song.
Yeah.
It's a rap based song.
More diversity.
Yeah. Me and Baby, and that's the thing. Like with the intro is like 2015, 2016 Tootsie, like the fans who first person, like yeah. really 2015 Tootsie, like when I came out, like I ain't even used to use auto-tune. I used to like rap, like I used to listen to people like J. Cole, like.
Yeah, I remember when I interviewed you, you was like J. Cole, yeah, you told me, and you named bars people, like
yeah,
people that can actually rap, yeah, you wasn't really naming
so,
no.
Like, that was like what I was listening to, like I wasn't listening to no like. So boom, then like I just like started to find my lane. Like this is who I am. Like I really could like make music. Like aside from the rapping, like I really could make music. So that's why when I made a post, I had made a post, and I don't know if you've seen it. I'm like, I feel like I'm the Drake of the upcoming artist.
Yeah, I seen that.
Yo, they ain't like that.
Yeah, a lot of I seen that. I seen
they ain't like that. But like in a sense, like everybody ain't gonna understand
it until it happened. Yeah,
until it happened, like. But my thing is, like, you crazy if you don't bet with me. You crazy to bet against me because I literally done did everything that I said I was going to do. I ain't never not succeeded in anything I said I was going to do. Like, I might have, and like I say, I don't believe in losses. Like, boom, everything a lesson. Mm-hmm. I might have bumped into some lessons, but boom, right after that lesson, I bounce back. Oh, boom, now I'm here. Like, I literally when I dropped out of school, I told my football coach I was going to make music. He laughed. Now I'm the same nigga. Go back to the school. All the jewelry, they love me. I'm pulling up in my cars. You know, this stuff.
Is the football coach still there?
No, the football coach not even there no more. They got a new football coach. And the new football coach rock with me more than the old football coach did. I'm talking about he gave me my old football jersey. Like, told me pull up to the game. And my school, crazy part is, my school going to the state champions, and guess what team they playing against?
Ooh.
Baby old school.
Oh my God, wait, both of y'all gotta go. Yeah,
so boom, right? This is what I tell them. I'm like, yo, but I won't lie though, like, love my team to death, and I got faith in them.
Don't say that.
I got to. Listen, love my team to death, and I got faith in them. They gonna have to come with it though. Them some big boys.
Okay.
I ain't gonna do that because I done seen them boys play like they.
Yeah.
Them boys like that. Like I got faith in them. They gonna have to come with it. Them some big boys. Real talk.
Okay.
That nigga old school look like college football players, bro.
Oh.
Yeah. Real talk. I told him I got 20K. I got 20 on my team. On my boys.
He took the bet.
He like, you sure? I ain't respond yet, but I'm gonna get back to him for sure. Maybe 15, maybe 75. Let's just show up to the game.
Let's show up to the game together. Let's show up and support. Now, what's next for Tusi? What does Tusi
want to accomplish that he hasn't accomplished yet?
Man, bro,
I want to get into movies.
Tyler Perry, you hear that?
Real talk, I want to get
into Madea.
I want to get into movies, bro. Like, that's the next step for me. You could be in movies, bro. You got a lot of personality.
It's coming, bro. It's so much stuff in the works, boy.
Yeah, you got a lot of personality, bro. You could be in movies, bro. For real, like, I'm talking about a major role in movies. But that's what I want to do. I want to be in movies, bro.
Now, musically-wise, what's next for Tusi?
Musically, bigger features.
Is there anybody that you want to work? Wait.
Yeah.
So I heard
through
a very close source that you were on a remix that just dropped.
Yeah. Something like that.
What? Flip. Can I get a thumbs up or thumbs down?
I can't say that.
Okay, I let it go. Look, I can't. That's all camera. I can't do that. But.
It's a lot of remixes around the.
Yeah, no, I hear about all of them before they, and I'm just like, and I was waiting for that one. I'm just like, oh, hell yeah.
You gotta hear it. I'll play it for you.
Okay, good.
So I'm playing for you.
Now, musically, is there anybody that you want to work with, like, just in general? Like,
I want to, you know, broaden my audience, feel mm-hmm. me? So, you'll be surprised, bro. I want to work with, like, you know who my dream collab is? Two people. I want to work with Billie Eilish. I like that picture right there, bro. That's why I look up to, for real. I just seen it. That's why I look up to, for real. Billie Eilish.
Uh-huh.
Like, that's my dream collab. Like, I want to be friends with her.
Oh.
Like, for real, I want to be friends with her. Like, we got to be friends. Be my friend for real. I don't even want nothing from her. Like, me and my girl love Billy. Like, okay. I want to be friends with her. That's my friend. In my head, that's my friend. Boom, Billy. And then, like, dream collab. I want to work with John Legend.
Ooh.
Like,
I didn't expect. See, the 2021 you, 2017, these answers wouldn't be nothing like this.
2017, I would have told you I wanted to work with Baby. Real talk.
It happened.
Real talk.
Everything that you said was going to happen is happening. Now, wait. You, I see you're super tight with BRS Cash.
Yeah, that's my boy.
Y'all two together.
He came to Vegas for my birthday. You know this man came to Vegas for my birthday and I didn't even see him.
What?
He went to the room. He went to the casino. Got drunk.
Probably lost some money.
Lost. Got drunk. Lost. Went to the room and was asleep like the whole day.
What the fuck, guys?
Yeah, he was turned up. My boy was turned up. Ask him about that. When you see him, ask that nigga what happened.
Understood. Well, listen, man. I appreciate you. More blessings to you.
Sure.
Everything that's coming your way, you deserved it. I called that shit in 17, 18.
Yeah. What you call next? What you predict next? Put it into
To be completely
honest. 5 years from now, where you see Tusi at, man?
5 years from now, you're going to be considered one of the greats in your lane.
Right.
5 years from now, ladies, y'all going to hate me for this, but you're going to have a kid.
Yeah, sure.
Already on the route that you're going. I'm gonna keep it 1,000, bro. Sure. Listen, you're 21, now, and the way you're married, speaking, bro. That's what I'm saying. Like, the way you're speaking, like me at 21, my mindset wasn't even on that.
Yeah.
Like, so I know, like, and I know you're serious, like, because sure. You ain't a nigga that cap.
Nah,
but sure. And then 5 years from now, I see a Grammy coming. I see a Grammy coming. Within the next 5 years. Like I said, you stay on the path that you on, you stay in your lane, and you keep being you and keep being consistent, bro. Nobody can fucking stop you.
I appreciate that, bro. I appreciate that shit.
Always,
this is a nigga that I'm believing this because, like, he really called, like, my future, what, 4 or 5 years ago?
5 years ago.
So 5 years
came from now. Right up here.
He called in another 5 years, I bet. Like, part two. We'll circle back.
You know who told him to do that contest, though?
Yeah, he told me to do the contest, though.
Oh, you want to do it at first?
Nah. I wasn't, because I just wasn't into that type of stuff. I was having fun. I was a young nigga.
Yeah, but see, and then the thing is, a lot of crazy flip, but a lot of people don't be thinking that it's realistic. Like, people just think niggas be doing it just to get their followers up, or...
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah, but nah, bro. But it's crazy, because everybody who wins, when they actually win, they say the same thing. Like, I wasn't even going to do it at first. This person made me do it because I just thought that niggas was just trying
to... But you know what that be, though? That be the good rappers, though. Like, the motherfuckers who really could rap, like, be like, I ain't about to do that. Like, I'm good.
Listen, man. Artists, if I do something, I mean it. I don't do anything that I say I can't do.
Yeah,
literally. Listen, man, I appreciate you. Congratulations on everything. The project, the album is incredible. Congratulations on that. I can't wait for the next one, next single, and then just everything. More prosperity to you and your relationship. Keep treating her like a queen, bro. Sure. Set the example for these young niggas out here, and even set the example for some of these old niggas who think it's cool to be 35 still running around with different women. Sure. Like, bro, I'm proud of you, and I mean that shit from the bottom of my heart.
Love the go, Goldie. Don't play with him.